Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Welcome on this second Sunday of Advent. Just a few announcements before we begin. Thank you for remembering to bring your non-perishable food items for the UH Food Vault. This is our monthly donation, so thank you for your generosity. This coming Tuesday, December 8th, is the Solemnity of the Immaculate Conception. We will have two Masses here at the Newman Center at 12:10 p.m. and 6 p.m. as a festive Mass. So all are invited to join us this coming Tuesday. If you are planning to park for the 12:10 p.m. Mass especially, please park behind the center or on the baseball field. This Wednesday, we will have our stream night. And this week we will be featuring Sister Joanne, who is a daughter of St. Paul, who will be speaking to us about the theme of Advent. And so if you're interested in joining us for stream, we will have it in person, but also online through Zoom. We will be putting the link soon on our Instagram page and also through our Flock Notes. So please look out for that if you're interested in joining us. If you haven't picked up an Advent Daily Reflections, Practice and Prayers booklet, we have lots available, so you can take one, take a couple, give to your friends. This wonderful Advent devotional from Sister Janet Schaeffler, who is a Dominican, and this is one way you can reflect on and pray more during this Advent season. So they're available at the small table over there. And finally, we have our second collection today, and that is for the Seminarian Education Fund. This Seminarian Education Fund is normally during the summer, but we moved it because of the pandemic. And we thank you for your continued generosity. This collection helps local seminarians, local men studying for the priesthood here for the Diocese of Honolulu. So thank you again for your generosity. Thank you. We said
thank you.
and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. To prepare ourselves for the sacred mysteries of God's love for us, let us acknowledge our sins, asking the Lord for his pardon and his strength. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, may no earthly undertaking hinder those who set out in haste to meet your Son, but may our learning of heavenly wisdom gain us admittance to his company, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Comfort, give comfort to my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and proclaim her that her service is at an end. Her guilt is expiated. Indeed, she has received from the hand of the Lord double for all her sins. A voice cries out, in the desert prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the wasteland a highway for our God. Every valley shall be filled in, every mountain and hill shall be made low. The rugged land shall be made a plain, the rough country a broad valley. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all the people shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. Go up onto a high mountain, Zion, herald of glad tidings. Cry out at the top of your voice, Jerusalem, herald of good news. Fear not to cry out and say to the cities of Judah, here is your God. Here comes with power the Lord God, who rules by his strong arm. Here is his reward with him. He is recompense before him. Like a shepherd who feeds his flock, in his arms he gathers the lambs, carrying them in his bosom, and leading the ewes with care. The word of the Lord.
Truth shall spring out of the earth, and justice
himself will give his benefits, our land shall heal it in peace. Justice shall walk before it and prepare the way of his death. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Glory to you, O Lord. The beginning of the Gospel of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. As it is written in Isaiah the prophet, "Behold, I am sending my messenger ahead of you. He will prepare your way." A voice of one crying out in the desert, "Prepare the way of the Lord, make straight his paths." John the Baptist appeared in the desert, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. People of the whole Judean countryside and all the inhabitants of Jerusalem were going out to meet him and were being baptized by him in the Jordan River. As they acknowledged their sins, John was clothed in camel's hair with a leather belt around his waist. He fed on locusts and wild honey. And this is what he proclaimed: "One mightier than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop and loosen the thongs of his sandals. I have baptized you with water. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus
Christ. Are you tired of 2020 yet? I am. This pandemic has really taken a toll on so many people, including myself, that my main prayer is, "Lord, when will this pandemic end? And if you are coming back soon, come now." I am tired of virtual meetings. I am tired of seeing a deserted university. I am tired of a quiet student lounge in Newman Center. I'm tired of all these restrictions that we must follow. Perhaps this was the feeling of the Israelites in exile in Babylon, and those who were left in Jerusalem and the surrounding areas. God's words through the prophet Isaiah are meant to give them comfort and hope. In some sense, it is a word for us, for our comfort and for our hope. Isaiah announces that the time of chastisement for breaking their covenant with God is about to come to an end. The time of exile, humankind's long separation from God due to sin, is about to end. To the exiles, God will lead them back to the promised land through the desert as he did when he freed their ancestors from the bondage in Egypt centuries before. But this time, it will be a shorter journey, not 40 years. As God revealed his glory to their ancestors, so he will reveal his glory to them. Just as the exiles from Egypt saw the glory of God, but still rebelled, the exiles from Babylon will see the glory of God and rejoice. The church applies this to us today as we recall the coming of the Messiah to save us. Israel's deliverance was meant to herald an even greater saving act by God, the coming of Jesus to set Israel and all nations from bondage of sin to sin, to gather them up and carry them back to God. Last Sunday, we heard Jesus say, "Be watchful and alert." But being watchful and alert is not enough. We must tend to our lives and clear the way. We are to make ready in our lives for the new coming of Jesus Christ in the present moment. Well, Jesus Christ has come in history, and he will come in glory. But he also comes to us here and now in mystery. But are we prepared and disposed to receive him? St. John Paul II once said, "Advent was a time of watchfulness, prayer, and deeper conversion." And so St. John the Baptist today in our gospel really proclaims in the desert and reminds us, make straight his paths. He was echoing what the prophet Isaiah says to us in today's first reading. In the desert, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the wasteland a highway for our God. You see, this season of Advent that we're in calls us to clean up our acts and straighten things up before the coming of the Lord. It is not a time for us to bargain or to convince God to act on our behalf. Why? Because God is already disposed towards us. I was listening to a podcast recently from Bishop Barron, and he was speaking about the first reading. And he was saying that the biblical God is not one that is far off and is sitting back and relaxing and that we go to him, but rather the biblical God is one who comes to us. So it makes so much sense that God sending his only begotten Son through on Christmas to become one with us in the flesh so that we can be saved. And I think so then the prophet is quite clear as to what is God's intention. God tells the prophet, "Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and proclaim to her that her service is at end, her guilt is expiated." You see, God is ready to heal our wounds and to forgive our sins. But he does not deprive us of our free will. And he allows us to respond to his initiation, to his coming to us. We just need to make room for him into our lives and offer it up in reckless abandon. There is a strong appeal in today's readings for us to change. For example, St. Peter urges us to conduct yourselves in holiness and devotion. And the ministry of the Baptist calls us to repent. We may be tired of how life is in 2020, but God never tires to help us get by. The words of God this first week's of Advent invites us to look more closely at our lives. And this is what we do at Advent, to clear a path for the Lord. And there are many things that we can do this season to prepare the way of the Lord. We can do a thorough examination of conscience. We can go to confession, attend daily Mass, read the Bible, spend time before the Blessed Sacrament, pray more during the day, every day, and the list can go on and on. But maybe we need to take a closer look at our complacency, at the evils around us, our smugness that set us apart from others, our preoccupation with wants, especially during this buying season, our negativity and lack of gratitude for God's many acts of kindness, our unwillingness to work with others to make changes in our world, or our holding back from someone in need. This is a different way that we can clear the path for God in our lives. And so the questions I think we need to ask ourselves this week are these. What valley in your life that needs to be filled? What mountain and hill that needs to be made low? Or what rugged land that needs to be made a plain? May you use those questions in your meditation this week to use this time of Advent to prepare the way of the Lord in your life. May we, my dear brothers and sisters, continue through this Advent journey by listening to the prophetic voices that we are going to hear through God's word. But most importantly, may we have the heart to heed to their call. Let us now respond to God's word by proclaiming what we believe. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. As we await the fulfillment of God's promise, let us offer prayers to the Lord, whose patience is our salvation.
For the Church, that it may herald the glad tidings of God's coming to gather and comfort all people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the world, that its striving for peace may foreshadow the new heavens and new earth where righteousness will be at home, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the oppressed, that worldly pride may be brought low, the downtrodden lifted, and the uneven ground leveled to become a highway for God's justice, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this Eucharistic assembly, that by leading lives of holiness and godliness, you may wait for the day of God and hasten its coming, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those gone before us, that found at peace without spot or blemish, they may receive from the Lord's hands the reward and recompense of life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our benefactors, friends, and supporters, that God will reward them for their kindness to us and continue to bless our ministry, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers on our website, and for those which we now mention.
For the end of this pandemic, for all those who've been affected by COVID-19 through illness and death, and in other ways, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord.
For continued healing for our Pastor Emeritus, Father Jack Ryan, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
Father, we are the people you have chosen to be your own, and we give thanks. Be our protection and our help at all times, and please answer these prayers through Christ our Lord. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Lord,
Be pleased, O Lord, with our humble prayers and offerings, and since we have no merits to plead our cause, come, we pray, to our rescue with the protection of your mercy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up
to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all his at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us in the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst when we are gathered by his love. And when as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. And grant that, by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and unto the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. And so, having called us to your table, Lord, confirm us in unity, so that together with Francis our Pope and Mary our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and with your entire people, as we walk your ways with faith and hope, we may strive to bring joy and trust into the world. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, with St. John Henry Newman, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, take away the sin. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Replenished by the food of spiritual nourishment, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that through our partaking in this mystery, you may teach us to judge wisely the things of earth and hold firm to the things of heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you for joining us on this second Sunday of Advent. Please join us for Sunday student dinner, takeout, right after Mass today. Also, I want to say thank you for all the students and parishioners who came yesterday for our semi-annual Unification Day. It was a nice day of cleaning our house, of worship for Christmas. So thank you for coming and joining us. And we hope that we'll have more opportunities to take care of our neighborhood center. We hope to see you this coming Tuesday for Immaculate Conception. Please have a blessed week and please stay healthy. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.